church we are in. What kind of a church is this?
Yes.
Lutheran. Lutheran. Oh. Who knows who those two people are?
Mrs. Holland.
Who?
Mrs. Holland.
Not Mrs. Halloran. No. Do you know who this is? It is not George Washington, although that's a good guess. Anybody else? God? No.
Excuse me.
Martin Luther! Well done!
Please!
That was Sam.
Okay. And his wife Katie Cole.
Brilliant.
So this is Martin Luther and Katie Luther here, and we're going to tell you a little bit about Martin Luther because he started our church. So we have named our church after him. So you want to hear a puppet show about that?
Yeah!
Okay, good. Here we go. I have a script for this one. Alright. Usually we just wing it. Alright. So Martin Luther lived about 500 years ago, around the time of Christopher Columbus discovering America. That's a long time, right? Well, about that time there was only one church, and that was the Catholic Church. There were no Lutherans, Anglicans, United Church, Presbyterians, none of that. So Martin was a Catholic, and he grew up in Germany. Eventually, when he was a young man, he decided to go to university to study law.
Goodbye, Mom! I'm on my way to school to study law!
Give me a hug, Martin. Bye now. I'm so proud of my Martin. Soon he'll be my son, the lawyer.
Yes. Well, kids, I need you to make me some rain sounds by tapping on your legs like that. Can we do that? Right. So it started to rain.
I better hurry and get to the university. It looks like a storm is coming. Help me, Sam! I think I'm going to die! But if I live, I'll finally clean out the garage! Okay, if I live, I'll become a monk!
Okay, stop.
It stopped! Oh, I should have stuck with the garage idea. I'm going home. Hey, Mom!
Yeah?
Change of plans. I'm going to be a monk.
A monk? Sorry. Are you crazy? You'll never have a home of your own. No wife ever will ever have children for me. I wanted my little children to call me Oma.
Poor mother. So Martin Luther became a monk, a man devoted to the service of God.
Oh, hi, Mom. Thanks for visiting.
Oh, Martin, what's wrong? I brought you a nice tuna.
Oh, Mom, thanks, but I can't eat that. I'm fasting this week.
Oh, no wonder you're so sad.
Oh, no, it's not that I'm so hungry. It's just, well, I spend all day praying, fasting, in confession, and even punishing myself. But I just know that I will never please God. You know, I think I will be going to hell, and I will never be good enough for heaven.
Oh, I just remembered. The head monk asked me to hand this to you. What is that?
Let's see here. Looks like he's sick of hearing me groan. He's ordering me to go to the university to study theology.
Huh? What's that?
Well, theology, it's like Sunday school, but it's all day, every day, and there's no crafts or games or donuts.
Sounds dull, but I'll come and help you tackle.
So Martin went to study theology, where he read the Bible a lot.
What did he say? All right, let me see in the Bible here. Oh, good Bible. Wait a minute. I've been trying for years to be good enough so God will save me from hell. But right here in Ephesians 2 verse 8 it says, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not from yourselves, it is the gift of God." Salvation is a gift from God. This is amazing. The whole Bible is starting to make sense now.
Hello, Martin.
Oh, hi, Mom.
I brought you some indulgence money.
Indulgence money? What's that?
You know, if you buy enough of these tickets from the church, you can buy a place in heaven, or at least left hand hell.
But the Bible says salvation is a free gift from God through faith in Jesus. I have to tell everyone, I have to change the church. Their teaching is all wrong. Hey everybody, hey church guys, listen to what the Bible says.
Well, from that time on, Martin Luther really stirred things up in the church.
Let me tell you about my heart.
Mrs. Luther, you're still here?
It's all that strudel. I highly recommend it. You know, Martin was kicked out of the church, and he spent a lot of time translating the Bible into German, and he got it printed so everyone could read the Bible for themselves. He got married, and he started his own church. People started calling it the Lutheran Church, which just sounds weird to me. But best of all, I got 6 grandchildren to call me Oma.
That's wonderful news, Mrs. Luther. Congratulations, Oma.
I'm going to make some strudel. Okay. Bye, Oma.
So that's the story of Martin Luther, and he did really shake things up in the church. He got everyone reading the Bible and believing what it says in the Bible and not making other stuff up. And that's who we named our church after. This month, we're sort of celebrating that because it's been 500 years since Martin Luther started all this. So can we say a big thank you to our puppet curtain holders and our puppeteers? Now, while Ryan goes back up there to get us to the piano, parents, I am doing something today to follow up on Martin Luther and the Bible. I'm doing a class over in the youth room on how to read the Bible with your kids. It'll be an overview of the Bible, sort of Bible for dummies, because we all need that. And it's going to be over there. When the kids leave, just follow me downstairs to the parish hall. We'll meet in front of the stage, and we will do a little class on reading the Bible to your kids. Thank you, Martin Luther, for getting us doing that.